Big applause.
Thank you, Charles. Good afternoon, everybody. I've just had a fascinating chat with Charles in the back room. You actually spend 10 minutes with him, and it's brilliant because I'm going to present, well, that's a very happy picture, but the first four or five slides are quite thought-provoking, a little bit depressing. And talking to him about Africa, where he grew up, there's so much energy, there's so much opportunity, and that is what delivering connected education can give Africa if we get it right. So now, inspiring pictures, but a few depressing facts that'll get you thinking. 70% of the population in sub-Saharan Africa are under 30. I'm telling you what you already know. In the next 20, think of the demographics of that, and in the next 20 years, there are going to be a further 1 billion people in sub-Saharan Africa. 2 billion people in sub-Saharan Africa, okay? And we are a bit concerned about how many people are crossing the Mediterranean right now. It's clearly going to get more complex and more difficult. ...49% of primary children do not go to school. That's 57 million kids. 57 million children don't go to school. Two weeks ago, I was on the Syrian border, bordering onto Turkey, and talking to refugees that had not had schooling for 6 years, and completely marginalized. Now, they haven't had literacy, or they're illiterate, they're innumerate, and they have life skills, but they're very different to how they're educated normally in school. These kids do not attend school. Think about what they're missing out on. And clearly this has an effect on school leavers. If they get to a school leaving age, they're probably in a farm somewhere. It's all subsistence farming. And then they're unemployed. And that's 60% of under 30s. And remember, we've got another 1 billion people coming. So we have to radically do something and deliver something that's not been possible in the past. So over the last 12 years, we've invested $1.2 billion in a host of satellites that deliver high-speed connectivity over EMEA, Europe, Middle East, and sub-Saharan Africa. And in an afternoon, you can have high-speed broadband literally anywhere in Africa. And I'm in charge of delivering the project. Predominantly, we deliver in East and South Africa. We have some fantastic projects in Kenya, and in Tanzania that I'm going to briefly speak about. If we deliver the right ed tech, then we can deliver after that the right employment opportunities, and that's what I'm also going to be discussing is ECHO, getting every child online but every community online to make it sustainable. Because it's all very well delivering a great ed tech intervention, but it will be a successful pilot project, and then when you run out of money, it ends. And I hate going around Africa seeing successful pilot projects that have then ended. It's a tumbleweed project. That's how I see it. And you see an awful lot of them. So sustainability is absolutely crucial. This is Avanti's 2020 plan. We're going to connect 100,000 schools. It sounds a lot, but we launched this less than a year ago. We've connected about 5,000 schools so far in 2017. And it's the 21st of June, and my mother's Swedish, so it's midsummer, glad midsommar. One would say, and we're halfway through the year, and we've done half of the 5,000. So it's looking good, but it's a big number to achieve. So this is a worry, because it shouldn't have done that. Okay, good. Project Imalango is the first project I wanted to briefly talk about. It's the project that we're delivering in Kenya. It's in 205 schools, where we deliver in the most marginalized places in Kenya. So we deliver the connectivity, and we deliver it, as I say, pretty much in an afternoon, depending on how long it takes to drive to that location. Remember, if you delivered fiber, it would possibly take, you know, in Africa, up to 20 years to build the fiber. We can deliver high-speed broadband in an afternoon. We deliver the hardware, so the connectivity, the hardware, the ongoing capacity training, because there is no point delivering internet connectivity into schools without capacity training, and it has to be ongoing. You can't just go into a school, train up the teachers, and then leave and think it's going to be okay. You have to revisit it every couple of weeks and months and continue that. And then we deliver localized content all in context. So it's not content that you just pick up from the bet show here in the UK, but you have to localize it and get it approved by the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of ICT. And then we deliver the sustainability plan, which is in a slide coming up. We deliver it into, we have 68,000 marginalized girls that we're delivering it to, and an effect on over 1 million kids in Kenya, which is pretty impressive. The other project is in Tanzania. We've capacity trained 8,000 teachers in Tanzania and 262 schools, and we deliver Wi-Fi hotspots into these schools to make them sustainable. So, on the back of that, most of the money for those projects came from international development funds. So DFID, USAID, UK Space Agency, that's how it normally works delivering these projects. But constituency incubation hubs is the first project that the government of Kenya have actually paid for into 1,160 sites. It's all about employability. So they're delivering connectivity into communities to deliver education programs for innovation, to deliver employability. And that's the first commercial large-scale project we've done for communities in East Africa. And we're just rolling out that now. I've got 3 minutes left. So as I hope I've managed to convince you in the last 7 minutes, broadband is undisputed force for economic and social change. You only need to read the reports from World Bank or McKinsey to say that immediately when you deliver connectivity, you see an upside of 1.6 in GDP. And that's in a fairly mature market. In Africa, it really is revolutionary. I don't use that term lightly. So I wanted to play you a very brief video about Echo, which is getting every child online in a sustainable way. So when the money runs out from an international development project, we can create sustainability in each community. So I'm going to play you a very quick video, and then we can discuss that. But essentially, it's delivering the connected school or hospital or police station or whatever, and then delivering a Wi-Fi hub where we sell small amounts of data to communities. And that money comes in, it's split between Avanti and the community, but it gives in perpetuity connectivity to the school. So they get connected for free in perpetuity. And that's what we're delivering in Tanzania and Kenya at the moment. And we have proof of principle projects in Zambia, Zimbabwe, South Africa, and Rwanda. So here's the video. There's the video. Thank you.
Deliver sustainable broadband to every rural school in Africa. Most African governments have limited budget or resources to deliver broadband to the population. Echo is fully sustainable broadband and could benefit 500,000 schools. Schools are fitted with solar cells to power the Avanti VSAT system, providing a satellite broadband connection to classrooms. A transmitter connects communities through Wi-Fi. The local community can download the Echo app and purchase broadband Echo credits. The app enables communities to pay via traditional methods and allows Echo credits to be transferred between users. Top-ups convert to broadband for schools. Once the app is downloaded, communities can register and buy Echo credits to connect to the Avanti community Wi-Fi hotspot. The app also allows users to transfer Echo credits between accounts or via traditional payments such as paying local merchants, credit card, or M-Pesa. The network infrastructure is already up and running in 1,000 East African locations. And with the initial phase funded by sponsors and donors, Echo is committed to delivering broadband to schools. Connected communities will power a sustainable digital future for Africa. All of this is possible today.
That's great. And with 12 seconds to go, that was my 10 minutes. So We're working with an awful lot of partners, partners that are paying for the rollout, but partners also to deliver, on top of the connectivity, content in education, for specifically for primary and secondary education. But we also deliver into universities, e-health centers, agri-tech, and e-financial services. Thank you.